Now, Tamsin, I'm reading through the book. It's not a heavy legal document like one may expect. It's actually hilarious and tongue-in-cheek. And you and Emma both admit that, like the rest of us, we're still trying to figure out what this damn cloud is. Was it a purposeful decision to write this in a kind of light-hearted, funny way?
Yeah, it absolutely was. It was a conscious decision that we made because it could very easily have slipped into a legal textbook. But we feel so strongly about this message that we really wanted to be a book that people could read. And it's a lot of content that we have to get through. So we took it, we made a conscious effort to really write it in a very conversational tone, what we like to think of as quite a bloggy tone, quite lighthearted, tongue-in-cheek. Because and some of these issues are very serious, and you know, sometimes we have to make a bit of a joke about certain aspects of social media. We really want it to be a book that people can read, and so we went away from making it a legal textbook. And you know, we're young as well. We're all trying to figure this out at the same time. And I think that there's a certain tone to the way that people interact on social media. Quite a humorous tone, and we try to capture that somewhat in the way in writing about social media, so that it all kind of it felt quite cohesive.
Reading through snippets of the book, I kind of got the impression that it was, I could imagine my best friend in my head telling me what I should or shouldn't be doing online. It's such a fabulous tool, and of course we want everyone to go out and buy the book, but could you sum it up for us? If Don't Film Yourself Having Sex could be summed up in one or two sentences, what would it be?
Well, Don't Film Yourself Having Sex is all about exercising personal online reputation management. It's about exercising responsible digital citizenship. And it's about helping you keep your job, helping your children stay in school, and helping you not get sued or sent to jail for what you do and say online. We know you're spending so much time online, and we're really here to help make sure that you're not getting in trouble because of what you're doing.
Well, Tamsin, we certainly all want to keep our jobs and have our kids stay in school. So thank you so much for writing this book and for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.